again. I love to walk. It's my favorite thing ever. I tell people it's my hobby sometimes just because I'm doing this most of the time when I'm not painting or working. But I think it's so good for me. Ever since I started walking, I just feel so much like myself. I read people as an exercise when I'm walking. So whether they're sad or happy or they're in a rush or they're talking to someone about something, I just like to try to think about what they must be going through or like where they're going, what kind of person they are, what hobbies they like to do. And I just make up fun stories for each person, which is pretty fun. I could do it for hours. I could do it for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, until I have to go do something else. I get more ideas. I see fun plants. I see cool things that inspire me in my art. I look at new places that I want to go eat at. The world is such a beautiful place, especially when you put some music on. Walking is peace, and a peaceful life equals a happy life. So, yes, go outside and walk. Today we are at Land's End, and it's one of the very few trails in San Francisco because it is a city, but it's really nice. I honestly forgot about it because I spend a lot of time at Golden Gate Park, but today we're here because I remembered and I really wanted to go on a walk. I love walking. I started walking in middle school because I lived on this really big hill and I lived kind of far away from my friends, so to pass time I would just walk up and down the hill over and over and over. I started walking through different pathways. I would go for an hour and then it turned into 2 hours, 3 hours. I fell in love with it. I fell in love with the fact that you don't need any equipment. All you need is yourself and your shoes and a little bit of time. And maybe if you have a dog. I had Coca at the time. As much as I love other people, I love being by myself because I get to just reflect on my character and also find new things that align with myself, whether that be new thoughts, or sometimes I listen to music and I find new songs that I like. Other times I will just listen to nature. I was actually listening to a podcast the other day that kind of inspired this video. It was called Time to Walk, and it was an episode with Jason Segel, and he said this one line that really stood out to me. He said, "These little moments where we reevaluate who we are keep us growing." And I think that's so true. I think that a lot of people aren't yet comfortable with being alone, and I think that's because they're not comfortable with who they are or what thoughts they have. They don't really know what that looks like, but I think the more that you do it, the more you come in touch with yourself. So I think it's just a matter of making yourself do it and going outside, because I didn't always feel comfortable, and now I can do just about anything by myself. Yeah. Another really cool thing about walking is that it's become a huge part of my art practice. I realized that one of my major strengths is the fact that I am able to pay attention to detail, noticing other people and their styles and the way they carry themselves and how that might be a component of their personality. Or I love finding just the tiniest little plants and using them in my pieces and molding them with whatever it is I'm going through. A lot of my art today is just indicative of what's going on in my emotional state. So I'll journal a lot and just kind of figure out what it is I'm going through, because sometimes I find myself feeling sad and a little bit conflicted in my feelings. But because I'm able to just reflect on myself, I can express myself in that way visually, and that's why I really like to draw. I've been drawing for as long as I can remember. Now that I like to surround myself with nature as my hobby, it's become a huge influence. The world is such a beautiful place, even though sometimes you feel sad in it. So I finished the trail, but I'm walking around here and there's some really gigantic houses. I don't really know where I am. Also, I think that I touched poison ivy. I was trying to take a video of blueberries and all of a sudden I felt it touch my arm. Oh shit. And I don't really know what to do in this situation, but the best thing I can think of is I'm gonna walk to the beach and wash it off. Whoa. I'm in China Beach now, and I'm here to wash off the poison ivy that I got in my arm. I'm pretty sure it happened right here. But this is a really nice beach, actually. I drew it when I was doing that 100 day drawing challenge, and I was actually sitting on that rock up there where those people are sitting, and I drew this view.